Blackstone Audio presents The Pink Tarantula, a novel in 9 episodes by Tim Wohlforth. This book is read by Stephen R. Thorne. Ralph and Patsy. I spotted her as soon as she entered the outside deck area of Raleigh's Ale House. Hard to miss. Spiked green hair, black lipstick, green eyes in sunken sockets. An emaciated, pale face suggested she had spent years on a Bosnian concentration camp. Enough damn metal piercing her nose, eyelids, lips, ears, and tongue, but I was afraid she'd clink if she smiled. No problem, because Henrietta never smiled. She had added more tattoos since I had last seen her. Most impressive was a rattlesnake that curled around her bare, thin, goose-pimpled left arm. The snake looked alive, wiggling its way through a sea of bluish cult tattoos. On her right arm, she had added a large red heart with Alvin in the center. I wondered who the lucky fellow was. No sense trying to avoid her. No way I could scoot out of her range of vision in my wheelchair. I damn well knew she was looking for me. I was stuck. And Henrietta was always trouble. Used to work for me as my legs. I kept firing her, but somehow she would find me and involve me in another of her crazy schemes. Henrietta was about as politically correct as Rush Limbaugh, seemed to delight in pressing my buttons. Thought the whole idea of a paraplegic private eye was a contradiction in terms. Sometimes I thought she had a point. That's why I made the mistake of hiring her. But most of the time, I'm more than happy to hide my wheelchair behind a website called Tom Bateman Investigations, and make a meager living doing skip traces and selling supposedly confidential information.
"There you are, Crip," she said as she approached my table. "Figured you'd be out here boozing when you should be working. Nobody's stupid enough to hire a Crip as a private eye."
"This why you looked me up to insult me?"
"Maybe,"
she said as she plopped down in a chair opposite me. She wiggled a crumpled pack of unfiltered Camels from out of a pocket in her faded, torn jeans, pulled out a bent fag, lit up, and puffed in my face. I coughed and glared at her. She knew I hated cigarette smoke. It was all part of her determination to torture me. In some weird way, I missed the lady. At least I knew where I stood with her. No phony patronizing.
"Actually, I want to hire you."
"You tried that on me before, never got paid." That she even offered money suggested she was in some deep shit. This would take time. I waved for the barmaid and ordered 2 pints of full sail for us.
"This time I got money."
That's hard to believe. I scanned the place. A crowd of Asian students had taken over 1 corner of the patio. They were going over physics tests. On the other side of us, a group of students babbled in French while puffing on gulwazes.
"Hooked up with Alvin," Henrietta said, explained the tattoo. "He's loaded. Bought me the rattlesnake tattoo as a birthday present."
"Lovely."
"I pay up front."
She pulled out a wad of bills and tossed 5 $100 bills at me. The lady was serious. I must admit it had been slim pickings recently on the web.
"What for?" "Help me feed a couple of puppies."
"You gotta be kidding."
"They're Alvin's, Ralph and Patsy."
"Cute names."
"Named after his parents. Alvin's sentimental."
"So why doesn't Alvin feed his own pets?"
"Can't. He's in Pelican Bay."
"The state's high security prison?"
"None other."
"What'd he do?" I asked.
"Nothing."
"Right, they just locked him up in Pelican Bay for jaywalking?"
"Ain't shittin'. It was Ralph and Patsy."
"You better explain." I knew I was in for one hell of a story. Nothing was ever simple with Henrietta. Henrietta blew more smoke in my face. "And cut puffing that cancer my way or I won't even listen."
"Fuck off!"
She started to get out of her seat and then thought better of it.
"Alvin's a farmer."
"Right. And he has a farm in Berkeley?"
"No, in Oakland."
"Come on, Henrietta, spill it. Exactly what was your farmer friend growing in Oakland?"
"Plants. Alvin's a goddamn genius. Green thumb. His plants were over 7 feet tall."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.